Hey guys, it's Deathblood reviewing the L115A3. As you can see, it's a lot better scope than the L96A1 GP standard. The magnification is tons better. It's a bolt action, obviously. The suppressor that's on it comes built on. It's a, I believe it's an S1 suppressor built in. It's obviously one hit kill, most bolt actions are. Except for the M24, which is a weak one hit kill. It can be if they have probably around 80 HP, I think. Let's go to the stats right away then. Damage is obviously 100% then. Portability is 45, which isn't bad. I mean, it's a good light sniper, actually, compared to the M107CQ, which is a beast, a tank, pretty much. Rate of fire is 10. It's a bolt action, so it's going to be expected. Accuracy is 91, which is fantastic, really. It's very accurate. Recoil is 65, which is standard for a sniper rifle, which doesn't matter since it's a bolt action. You have to reacquire the target anyway. Now, it's really laggy right here. I don't know when I rendered if it's going to be better or not. It's when I sped up the footage. It seemed to be a lot laggier, but so just stick with me. I'm sorry if it is laggy when it renders. I hope it's not. I think it's just because I'm publishing a video right now, rendering, and doing all kinds of stuff. So I think it's just my screen. This sniper is definitely worth buying. It's a great sniper rifle. I don't have any disregards of buying this. I'd buy it again. It's 29,900 NX permanent, which is what all the sniper rifles are, and it's definitely, I would put this right up there with the M200 Ghillie, actually. I think they're both, these two are the best sniper rifles you can probably buy, excuse me. This is part one of the review. Like I said, I'll be doing two parts. This is part one, and then, I guess, if you didn't watch my other review, I'm going to be doing part one with a friend, part two in a real game. So, I guess I'm gonna let the music take what you do.